Good evening. Oh, I need a little more energy. Good evening.
Good evening.
Oh, much better. My name is Patricia Johnson, and I would like to welcome you to the Martin Luther King Speech and Essay Contest Finals. This is the 16th year that the Palmetto Youth Center has hosted this event. The committee received 227 essays from middle and high school students throughout Manatee County addressing this topic. Dr. Martin Luther King Jr. said, "Injustice anywhere is a threat to justice everywhere. Explain what his quote means to you and how it relates to modern times." The Martin Luther King contest is comprised of a written and an oral component. The written entries were evaluated based on how well the student complied with the rules of the contest, how they addressed the topic, the effectiveness of the introduction and the conclusion, and really how innovative their approach to the topic was. Tonight's presentations will be evaluated based on the delivery of the speech. Each finalist will be asked to present his or her essay tonight. Please state your name, your school, and your grade level before you begin. That's what, name, school, and grade level. Before we begin, I would like to first recognize the judges for this evening. From the Palmetto Youth Center Board of Directors, I would like to recognize Lily Covington. Frida Bellamy. Kenyatta Randall. And from the Bradenton Herald, Joan Crowder. We will begin the competition with the middle school category, and then immediately following them, we'll hear from our high school students. There will be 10 middle school students competing tonight and 11 high school students competing tonight. We will begin with contestant number one in the middle school category, who is Sully Miley. Just as a reminder, if you can talk directly into the mic, we have METV broadcasting tonight, so if you can do that, that would be wonderful.
My name is Sully Miley. I'm in eighth grade at Nolan Middle School. Martin Luther King. Those three words mean so many different things to so many different people. While the things King fought for may seem rudimentary to us today, they positioned him as a political radical in his time. King was a pioneer, a visionary, and for many, a hero. Many of his most famous quotes still resonate in today's world. In a letter from his cell in Birmingham jail, King wrote, "Injustice anywhere is a threat to justice anywhere." Many people take this in reference to terrorism or even war, but I see it a little differently. In America, we don't have to look abroad to find injustice. Take a look around. The biggest threat I see to our nation is not a terrorist organization thousands of miles away, but the epidemic of police violence in our country. SWAT teams at peaceful protests, tear gas used on civilians, a young boy being shot because he was holding a toy gun in a park. If we are to stop injustice from threatening our freedom, the place to start would be right here in our own country. King's quote confronts the idea that we must fix wrongdoing anywhere to make people safe everywhere. If we want everyone in our great nation to live in true freedom, we must eliminate the militarized police force that currently plagues our country. When police show up at a protest, a few officers in squad cars would often be sufficient. Escalation towards violence tends to occur when multiple tanks arrive at the scene, fully cloaked in riot gear with semi-automatic assault rifles. We as Americans have the right to protest. When we exercise it, we should not do so in fear of being riddled with bullets. As free Americans living under the Constitution, we have the right to peaceful protest. The most worrisome part of this issue, however, appears in cases of single-victim police shootings. Too many cases have occurred recently in which police officers have taken the roles of judge, jury, and executioner. There are clearly times when an officer's own life is in danger and they must shoot someone on a moment's notice, but these are not the types of killings I'm referring to. I'm talking about summary judgments against unarmed, vulnerable, and sometimes completely innocent civilians. If a suspect is handcuffed, they should not be shot. If a suspect is unarmed and running in the opposite direction, they should not be shot. And most of all, if a suspect is clearly posing no threat to the officer's safety, they should definitely not be shot. Our Constitution gives us the right to a fair trial and describes the process through which it is carried out. Nowhere does this process allow for summary execution. We entrust our police officers with a great amount of authority. With that power comes tremendous responsibility. Too many police officers have been misusing this power and consequently breaking the trust we have placed in them. Even more frightening is the absence of a meaningful internal response to this grave problem. Because the criminal justice system has failed to respond, the American people need to come together to bring an end to this injustice. We need to be able to peacefully exercise our First Amendment rights without the threats of tear gas and bullet wounds. Our internal security is being threatened by the very people we have tasked with protecting us. In order to protect justice for everyone, we must prohibit this injustice from being inflicted on anyone.
My name's Alexa Bland. I go to Carlos E. Hale Middle School, and I'm in eighth grade. In America today, when we hear the word justice, it usually tends to mean revenge. When Martin Luther King Jr. heard the word justice, he thought of it as peace. Today in America, we are so focused on taking what is ours that we don't seek out the peace and tranquility our country really needs. We have caused so many troubles in our country, and we have caused so much hurt, all because we wanted what was ours. In 1774, when we declared freedom from the British, all we wanted was peace. The American Revolution was us telling the British that we didn't want their taxes and definitely didn't want to be under the rule of their king. Throughout the years, that peace has slowly slipped away. Sure, most countries have their hiccups, but some slowly become warring countries. In Afghanistan and Iraq, these once peaceful nations are torn apart by dictatorships and terrorists. When Martin Luther King Jr. said the words, "Injustice anywhere is a threat to justice everywhere," he's basically saying that if there isn't peace in one little spot in our country, it will cause all the peace throughout our nation to crumble. This quote definitely relates to modern times in its own way. During the elections, lots of people were at war with each other due to the feud between Hillary Clinton and Donald Trump. I've heard reports of families that were split up because they had different views on what this country needed. Friends grew to hate each other, all because they disagreed on who our country needed to keep us going in the right direction. A good deal of peace in our country has retreated, all because Donald Trump became our president. The frequency and number of protests that erupted after the election are testimony to the erosion of peace in our country. We need peace to keep our country united. That was the Founding Fathers' ideas, to keep our country at peace and in unity. Do you really think this is what the Founding Fathers would have wanted the America they fought for to become? Injustice anywhere is a threat to justice everywhere. We all need to put our differences and our opinions to the side and understand we are what helps keep America intact. If we don't stick together, our country will fall apart. I have faith that our country can put its differences aside and see what we all really need. Peace. As Martin Luther King Jr. once said, darkness cannot drive out darkness, only light can do that. Hate cannot drive out hate, only love can do that. All that we need is peace. That's all our Founding Fathers wanted us to have, was tranquility. Our country will fall to pieces if we don't have serenity. Justice is a key element in keeping our country in unity. And isn't it justice that makes us the amazing United States of America?
My name is Carly Baker, and I go to Carlos E. Hale Middle School, and I am in eighth grade. Justice is equality. Everyone is treated equal, and no one reigns above the law. Injustice is unfairness. Broken laws and humans believing they can rule above the law or push others down in a chasm of mistreatment and misery. Martin Luther King Jr.'s quote, "Injustice anywhere is a threat to justice everywhere," rings true in our everyday lives. When one person gets away with treating others like vermin, it seems it's deemed acceptable. Without justice to crush these deeds, our society would spiral into chaos. Injustice is all around us. Mistreatment around every corner and crime bleeding out every street. I have witnessed much injustice, a lot of unfair treatment and horrible actions. People at school being tripped or called names because of the color of their skin, the way they dress, or how much money their family has. Some kids think it's okay to put a thunderstorm of sorrow and rejection over other human beings. This cloud of gloom rains down on their targets, making them wonder what they could have done to deserve such corruption. Once someone witnesses this, they believe it's okay to treat others the same way. This ruins the ideas of equality and fairness in our society. Unjust acts spread like a virus, infecting all the people around it. The only way to beat this coil of sickness around us is to stop it at its source. Justice acts like a vaccine against a discriminatory activity. Just as Martin Luther King Jr. did, we need to stomp out unequal feats in our everyday lives. Our lives need to become full of justice. Justice is defined as conformity to the principles of righteousness and rectitude in all things. In Webster's dictionary, this simply means justice is doing what's right, having integrity, treating others the way you'd like to be treated. If all people stopped using justice in their lives, then we would live in a country full of disarray. But that is not the country we live in. We live in a country full of revolutionizers, a country that is home to heroes, a country that will not give in to injustice. Honestly, Martin Luther King's quote is tugging on me. It dares me to do something. It calls out to me to only commit deeds justly. It wants me to fix the acts of injustice somehow, just as Martin Luther King Jr. did. He had a dream of equality and he ran with it. He was not just going to stand by and watch injustice swarm around his society. It seemed impossible for him to make a change, but he did it anyways. To conclude, Martin Luther King Jr.'s quote means to me that injustice to one person can warp itself into a monster of destruction. We need justice to slay this deadly beast. Without it, we would have a toxic atmosphere lingering in the air of all the wrongdoings in our lives. Martin Luther King Jr. did not let injustice stand in the way of his dream. He reached for the stars. He brought back equal rights shimmering in the palm of his hand. He shared it with the world and banished much injustice. Now his quote will always be whispering in my ears. It will be begging me for help. It will be asking me, what can you do to make a difference? How can you spread justice?
Hi, my name's Allison Whiteman. I'm from Carlos E. Hale Middle School, and I'm in the 8th grade. Martin Luther King Jr. once said, "Injustice anywhere is a threat to justice everywhere." What does this mean to me? This means there should be peace among all people. This means no matter what gender, race, or religion a person is, they should be treated as if they were any other regular person. This means people need to start acting as if nobody's strange just because they are different. This means we, as human beings who care for one another, need to put an end to unnecessary violence. This means we can stop unkind acts that may take part in the future by putting an end to this segregation that still goes on today. To me, this means if we can create peace among everybody, then we can stop injustice in the future. Today, our goal should be to strive for world peace, to seek justice, to find ways to bond with others, to create a place where everybody, including you, can be safe and not have to worry about others tearing them down. It means to not yield to others' cruelty, but instead use it as motivation to be even kinder. Think of it this way. If you drop a penny and leave it there, somebody is bound to acknowledge it and pay it forward. When that person acknowledges it, they may even pick it up. Same goes for acting nice to somebody. The person you act kind to or do good deed for will probably acknowledge it. Maybe cause them to feel warm inside, or they might feel as if they should do something nice for somebody else. These small actions that you can do may have a cause and effect on people's lives. Don't get me wrong, we have come a long way since the 1800s, when white people were allowed to treat African Americans as if they were inanimate objects, there to serve their everyday needs. Could you imagine the greatness that could be achieved if we take it even further? Then again, the cause and effect chain won't happen every time somebody does a certain action. First of all, it requires someone to commit a kind-hearted action. That's not all. People have to be able to appreciate the small acts people are doing for them. They have to be grateful. Although it sounds easy, it's not. When a person has gone through a lot, sometimes it's hard to make them feel positive again. Even if somebody's just having a bad day, it's difficult to turn their mood around. The key is to keep being kind. Don't let somebody make you feel so bad that you feel you need to do the same to others. Don't give up, because eventually things will turn out to better you if you did the right thing. Although sometimes you may feel terrible, don't take it out on others. That will not benefit them in any way. If you were kind to that person, they may return the favor. It won't be easy achieving peace and justice among everybody, but it's worth a try. Could you imagine a world where everybody is kind to one another and people do things from the goodness of their hearts? You would see people able to be themselves and not have to worry about being judged or pressured by society. Everybody could be happy and enjoy life while it's still there. For what it's worth, I believe we can create world justice and stop the cruelty to come. So the next time you think you should do something, ask yourself, is this kind? Will this affect them in a good way? Will this cause somebody to feel good inside? Depending on your answer, you should decide whether or not this will help us on the journey to a just and happy world.
Hello, everybody. I'm Aiden Delk. I go to Carlos E. Hale Middle School, and I'm in the 8th grade. Injustice is unfairness. For Martin Luther King, everything he fought for was justice. He fought for the better of the worse in his situation. He fixed a major problem in America, segregation. If he hadn't done this, we would be split by it and judged based on it. MLK was correct. Any negative can overpower a positive. Disease for anyone, anywhere, is injustice. Alzheimer's disease has many injustices. Not making your own decisions, a loss of freedom, and losing your dignity. Cancer is also a disease that is unjust. My grandmother survived breast cancer and is completely healthy now, although some people aren't as lucky. Remission isn't recovery. The cancer could now just be undetected in your system, and it always isn't completely removed. For Martin Luther King, his injustice was racism. Now it could be disease, unequal wages, or discrimination. Justice is served every day, from arrests to serving in the military. MLK showed justice like no other. He showed justice like no other. He helped America get out of its biggest problem, segregation. Despite the odds of MLK changing anything, he pushed through to the light on the other side of the tunnel. Now, his actions inspire people. Now, his actions inspire people to stand up for what is right and not to be the smaller man in the situation. He showed that he has a dream and he can pursue it, as should you. Freedom is never voluntarily given by the oppressor. It must be demanded by the oppressed. This is talking about the troubles MLK went through to help America remove segregation. MLK was faced with many odds, from racist people to brutal police. Rallies were held as him as the leader and the one to be following. He spoke at over 2,500 different events with about 450 speeches a year as the predominant leader of civil rights. This made him a target while he was fighting for what is right. He spoke to all on equal races and wanted to be heard. Unfortunately, he was shot and killed at the balcony of a dinner party. Modern times have changed what is being fought for, but the quote has stayed the same. This letter from the Birmingham jail showed that he cared. He risked his life to make America equal. Rallies today are similar to MLK's rallies. They're peaceful, as the Constitution states is legal. There will always be protests about something, racism, discrimination, or even the President of the United States. In conclusion, MLK's quote continues to be truthful today. Though he may face many different injustices, he solved the biggest of all, segregation. If he didn't stand up for what was right, we would be separated today by race. Although there are many challenges we face, one is fixed. Thank you.
Hi, my name is Simone Leong, and I'm an eighth grader at Carlos C. Hale Middle School. Martin Luther King Jr. was a noteworthy advocate for civil rights. Probably one of the most well-known spokespersons for equality among all races, many people remember and commemorate Martin Luther King Jr. for his acclaimed I Have a Dream speech. But Martin Luther King contributed and sacrificed so much more for the civil rights movement. Many of his other distinguished speeches in quotes are forgotten under the enormous shadow of Luther's renowned speech. For example, the quote, "Injustice anywhere is a threat to justice everywhere," is powerful and contains many layers of meaning that still relate to modern times. So the significance and message of the quote can still be seen in society today. The quote, "Injustice anywhere is a threat to justice everywhere," is compelling and powerful. The meaning of the profound quote is still the problem in today's society. In recent events, the question of justice and equality has been constantly brought up. Our certainty of justice in society has been shaken, and suddenly we aren't so sure that we are upholding the values that so many before us have fought and died for. This quote relates to modern times in numerous ways. The danger mentioned in the quote can still be seen today. It can be seen today in the forms of violent protests, demonstrations, and riots. The problem of injustice is still being debated over today and hasn't diminished in the past 50 years. And as an Asian American, I have experienced many forms of racism and stereotypes firsthand. This quote especially is important to me because I can relate to it and I have experienced injustice firsthand. Even though many civil rights leaders have fought unceasingly for the idea of equality to be present in society, it is still being threatened today. To me, this quote means that any form of inequality in any race threatens the balance in our society. It demonstrates how the smallest amount of discrimination can set off an entire series of inequality. This quote is prominent in my life because I have gone through the hardships described in the quote. It means that any act of injustice can threaten all the progress that we have made on civil rights and equality for all. The quote, "Injustice anywhere is a threat to justice everywhere," is powerful and influential. The topic of justice described in the quote still relates to modern times. Acts of injustice happen everywhere in society, and they all threaten the slightest bit of balance that we have managed to achieve over countless protests and events. Just one small act of injustice can have a consequence severe enough to offset all the progress that we have made to achieve equality among all races. Martin Luther King Jr. was a passionate advocate for equality and justice. His sacrifices and contributions to the civil rights movement have shaped our society to what it is today, and the lasting effects of it can still be seen today. The quote, "Injustice anywhere is a threat to justice everywhere," is powerful and profound. It means that any act of discrimination, however small, can be tremendous enough to spark injustice everywhere. This means that we must uphold Martin Luther King Jr.'s legacy and values. We must protect our small precious amount of equality that we have managed to gather. We have to block injustice from leaking into society and stop it from controlling our thoughts and actions. But most importantly, we have to prove that every dream can be achieved by not the color of our skin, but by the strength of our character.
Good evening, my name is Bella Dombrowski. I'm from Carlos E. Hill Middle School and I'm in eighth grade. "Injustice anywhere is a threat to justice everywhere," says Martin Luther King Jr. This quote may mean many things to each individual. I'm here to tell you what it means to me. The quote to me means that if you are struggling in one aspect of life, the rest will be affected. For example, a bad grade in a class. If you fail that class, then your future is affected. Same way with segregation. Knowing that you're black can limit you from doing certain activities and determine what you can and cannot do. In modern times, this quote can relate to many other things. This quote, in modern times, can relate to the constant controversial arguments of our political parties. Being weak in those can affect how we carry out in our work. If we focus our attention on the negatives of each other, then the duties we have are not carried out properly. Martin Luther King Jr. said this quote about segregation, but relates to almost every aspect of daily life. Every action has a consequence. This is what most people do not understand these days. Everything you do is observed. Teens these days are especially careless with their actions. We need to take into consideration that with the widespread use of technology, there is even more consequences for our actions. When injustice is done to one, justice, all justice is at risk. When you bully someone, you are putting their justice at risk as well as your own. The bully could lose potential friendships and put their already existing friendships at stake. Said person who is being bullied could lose all their friends because of a nasty rumor. This is a form of injustice that affects justice everywhere. Bullying has taken on new forms throughout technology and affects everyone's justice everywhere. Just as segregation, lethal words were thrown at African Americans and almost ruined their reputation as a whole. Martin Luther King Jr. makes a valid point with his statement and should be shown in schools across the globe. Teens are becoming more and more careless with their actions. They should be aware of all consequences at all times. We choose to be careless because we, teens, think nothing of it anymore. There are no limits on our communications, so being careless is almost in our nature. This shouldn't be happening, and it needs to be taken care of. I believe that broadcasting this quote and in-depth explaining it to students can change the way they think. To conclude, Martin Luther King Jr. has made thousands of very valid and relevant points. He has changed America for the better and taught us things not only about segregation, but life in general as well. We should all step back and observe his actions for a moment and learn from him. Martin Luther King Jr. has changed the past, present, and future. His actions brought justice and whited out the injustice for all. He pledged for good and knew what would happen because of that. He took the risk for justice, and we should too. We should honor Martin Luther King Jr.'s legacy and continue to educate ones on the great accomplishments he's made. Thank you.
Hello, my name is Hannah Ramson. I go to Hale Middle School, and I'm in eighth grade. Dr. Martin Luther King Jr. is quoted, "An injustice anywhere is a threat to justice everywhere." He wrote that while in Birmingham jail during the Civil Rights Movement. I believe that he meant that one small event or idea could change everything. He was saying that we were all connected to each other, and one action could end up affecting you, me, and the people around us. Even a minor, Social media is even more influential today than in the past. Facts can be shared immediately. Events can be recorded and viewed by all. Martin Luther King Jr. fought for everyone who was discriminated against. I believe that this is relevant today, given the events happening currently. Today, discrimination is creeping back into our politics. What I think King meant by his quote is that one injustice can end up affecting you, not some random person. His quote explains that our world is small and everyone's affected. Allowing terrible ideas in our lives like discrimination and racism would become normal again. Consider this, if these actions became acceptable, we would hurt each other and we would wrongly act against another group of people. Obviously, from past experiences, this never ends well. I believe that this quote is meant to be inspirational and maybe a warning to anyone who wants to hurt each other because they're different. When you judge another based on how they are different, it makes you look bad and others begin to disrespect you. When this happens, it could possibly degrade your community, causing unrest between everyone. Martin Luther King Jr.'s quote is still relevant today during the presidential campaign. One of the candidates, who is now president-elect, stated that all immigrants coming from Mexico were rapists and murderers. Another campaign promise of his would ban all Muslims entering America. He said degrading things about minorities and women in general. Now that Donald Trump is president-elect, he'll have to be more responsible with his words and actions. In the U.S. Constitution, it states that people have the right to tear down their government if they're not happy with it. Some people are exercising this right with a new president with protests. Throughout Mr. Trump's history, he has made fun of, targeted individuals who are different. America needed people like Dr. Martin Luther King Jr. to point out the proper way to civilly express their feelings. Dr. King taught how to peacefully protest. America's a land of immigrants, and we all need to learn how to value those differences. Everyone should be allowed to peacefully be who they want. Our new president-elect should look back to the past and see what we've learned. Be more kind to those who are different. People who are different shouldn't be left out of my America. President-elect Trump has the power to choose his cabinet. Those advisors will help him make choices. I hope he chooses a good team that is respectful. I hope he listens to what the people want. And he does his best for America. My hope is that our new president will help to eliminate injustice because he has the power to change our country. The one small change of voting by many individuals led to a big change for a president. Dr. King did his best to help America. I hope our new president will do the same.
Good evening. My name is Darius Beckford. I go to Carlos E. Hale Middle School, and I'm in eighth grade. Webster's Dictionary defines justice as the moral principle determining just conduct, and injustice as an unfair or unjust act. Martin Luther King Jr.'s quote, "Injustice anywhere is a threat to justice everywhere," is something that I strongly agree with. I interpret this quote as meaning that if some unfair act is seen as acceptable in one place or instance, then the act will occur in other places or instances, and people or society will think it's acceptable as well. Martin Luther King Jr.'s idea and dream to have every part of our nation treat people of different races, religions, and genders as equals is something I respect greatly. Many people have experienced injustice, including people in my family. At times, it is difficult knowing someone thinks badly about you or treats you differently when you've done nothing wrong. This is shown almost daily on the news with acts of discrimination and violence. Sometimes an injustice can be obvious. For example, when an 8-year-old boy was shoved down while entering his school and told to go back to working in the cotton fields by another 8-year-old attending the school. This is an example of how injustice is spread. If the 8-year-old was never exposed to this kind of talk, either at home or in the media, this would have never happened. Children aren't born knowing how to perform injustices. They are taught through others' actions or inaction. The media portrayal of different races, religions, and genders is an example of an injustice threatening justice. The stereotypes they promote can lead to obvious and less obvious unjust actions. A boy was walking through a store and was being followed due to having darker skin. This happens more than most people think. While it isn't harmful physically, it tends to build anger and frustration in the people being treated unfairly. What all this means to me is that no person should be treated differently based solely on the color of their skin. When Martin Luther King Jr. said that meaningful quote, you could tell he wanted a nation that is joined together and sets aside their differences to become united. He did not want people to tear each other apart, splitting the country into separate pieces. Martin Luther King Jr.'s quote is even more relevant today as more and more injustices are popping up in the news coverage and social media. Many people are still being judged by their color, religion, and sexuality. Progress was made during and after the Civil Rights Movement due to Martin Luther King Jr.'s and others' dedication to making America a better place for all people. Racism and other discriminations are now generally seen as wrong, and in some cases are protected by the law. His dream of all people being treated equal was coming true, and people were more accepting of others' differences. There are a few people who still treat people unfairly due to their race, religion, or gender. If these people are allowed to perform injustices, more people will join in, just like how segregation started. Someone decided to separate black and white people and put them on different trains. This caught on and other things were made separate, like water fountains and even schools. Recent condoning of injustices by influential people has been seen in the media. This has led to citizens performing more and more injustices in these people's names. I hope this justice doesn't cause our country to lose ground on the progress that was made. I hope that people will not accept even one injustice. I hope Martin Luther King's and others' hard work, dedication, dreams, and sacrifices will not be in vain. Thank you.
Hello, I am Luke Wilson from Hale Middle School, and I am in eighth grade. The quote, "Injustice anywhere is a threat to justice everywhere," as written by Martin Luther King Jr. when he was in the Birmingham jail, is extremely true and meaningful. If anywhere in America, or the world even, there is injustice, it can spread everywhere. In modern times, if the government is corrupt and unjust, the country as a whole will then become corrupt and unjust. The quote is from a letter that Martin Luther King Jr. wrote while he was imprisoned in a Birmingham jail. In the same letter, he states that he's at the jail by choice. He said he's there to spread freedom and that he is there because injustice is there. He relates his journey to spread freedom to St. Paul's journey to spread the gospel. The full quote is, "I cannot sit idly by in Atlanta and not be concerned about what happens in Birmingham. Injustice anywhere is a threat to justice everywhere. We are caught in an inescapable network of mutuality, tied in a single garment of destiny. Whatever affects one directly affects all indirectly. Never again can we afford to live with the narrow provincial outside agitator idea. Anyone who lives within the United States can never be considered an outsider anywhere within its bounds." To me, this quote means that if there is even a little injustice anywhere, like in a court, it can spread to everywhere. The courts will soon all become corrupt and the guilty will not be punished. The guilty will then run free and crime will be everywhere, threatening justice. The criminals will have control of all the businesses and everything outside of the government. After the criminals have control of everything outside of the government, they will take control of everything inside the government. Finally, they will start taking control of the world with or without the need for force. This quote means to me that even a little injustice somewhere can threaten all justice anywhere by spreading and overtaking it. This quote relates to modern times because it would be, with the current government, easy for injustice to spread, even though it would be hard for the injustice to start in the first place. Injustice would probably never start with our current government because it is fair and just. But on the off chance that it does start, it would be extremely hard to stop. The injustice would spread through first the country and then the rest of the world. This would definitely threaten justice everywhere, as it would soon be overcome by the injustice as it spreads throughout the world. The quote, "injustice anywhere is a threat to justice everywhere," is very true because injustice can and will grow if a little is left to thrive. The quote written by Martin Luther King Jr. is significant now because of how injustice can flourish. To me, the quote means that injustice can spread and get rid of justice elsewhere. Martin Luther King Jr. was trying to forewarn and stop injustice in order to create a world that is free and just.
Hello, I am Sarah Hampton. I am from Manatee High School and I'm in the 10th grade. Ideas are like wildfires. They can spread rapidly or be stopped in the blink of an eye. Wildfires burn almost anything it touches, so barely anything is left unscathed. Everything has a limit, and if it is not put out by something else, it will have nothing else to burn and die out. Sometimes these ideas collapse on themselves without the need of anything else. Nonetheless, these ideas can be destructive as a fire and be extremely detrimental to those affected by it. In today's modern world, ideas can be easily spread through the web and social media. Ideas are different because of the opinions people have. Each person is unique, even though their opinions can be similar to others. That is how people become friends and stick together on the web. Their opinions spread online and can counter other ideas that may be conflicting. This can erupt into a scuffle on the web, but most of the time it doesn't cause a catastrophe and suddenly fades back into obscurity as other ideas take over. Modern technology, along with ideas, move and update very fast, so it is impressive to see an idea last very long. In the past, people would believe almost anything they heard if they heard another saying it. Since the only real way was to read the newspaper or look on TV, anyone who didn't have those items were forced to believe it. Today, if a person hears a statement, they can look on a phone or computer to see if it is true. If it is true, they are likely to believe it, since it came from the internet, and a number of people believe things that are on the internet. Once a belief is set in, it can be hard to change it immediately. Opinions are attached to personalities, and a personality makes it difficult to change its opinion. Persuasion is difficult for an argument, and if they succeed, a new person joins a group of that same idea. Opinions determine if an idea is good or bad. Personalities can disagree with opinions, different, or ignore them altogether. If the different opinion becomes bothersome, it may cause conflict with its opponents. Those opinions can stop the bad opinion or be crushed by it and allow the bad opinion to spread. If it spreads enough, it may not be stopped. If the good opinion becomes strong enough and its power can destroy the other, this will always be repeated, and it has, along with time and technology. The oldest things can disappear the fastest or stay the longest, depending on its competitors. Ideas are created all the time when there is no way to stop them. It would be very difficult to stop the train of thought, which makes opinions and personalities forever until death. Every day there are ideas that are destroyed as well. There is no way to stop the constant creation of ideas.
Hi, my name is Madison Lee. I'm in 10th grade and I'm from Manatee High School. Martin Luther King Jr. was a very sagacious man. King spoke a great number of speeches throughout his life and shared his wisdom with the world. He had a wonderful perspective on life and saw the beauty in everyone. One thing that King was good at was bringing the truth to people's attention. Martin Luther King Jr. once said, "Injustice anywhere is a threat to justice everywhere." This quote, "Prize the blindfolds off of our nation's eyes to see through the unjust system we had." King helped us realize the reality of injustice in our wrecked world. Nobody really pays close attention to how unfair our justice system was, even to this day. Martin Luther King Jr.'s quote is extremely accurate. You have to look at it deeply to understand what it stands for. It means that people see injustice everywhere and look the other way without stopping it. That is, unless they are experiencing injustice themselves. So if we allow something bad to happen in one area of the world that is unjust, then we are setting an example to allow these injustices to happen somewhere else in the world that is unjust. Also, when injustice is served to one person, others do not usually consider that it could happen to them. They think that it is a shame, but then they walk away from the situation. Everyone is supposed to be treated equally. That is a rule. But even to this day, that rule does not apply. We as humans do not treat everyone the same. Unfortunately, it is our nature. Although we humans do not treat each other equally, we still live in the same world and we are affected by what happens in this world. Everyone is affected if we allow injustice to happen anywhere at any time. If people continue to allow these injustices to happen, then injustice will continue to spread. Some people see unjust things happen to people that are different than they are, and they ignore it as if it is okay because they do not believe it'll happen to them. However, the truth is, any unjust actions to anyone are not okay. All people were created equal and are equal. All people should be treated the same regardless of race, religion, or color. Dr. Martin Luther King Jr. was trying to speak the truth and spread his knowledge through his quote. Today, in our world, people still do not get the equal rights they deserve. Racism is still a problem in schools, workplaces, and everywhere. Profiling of people based on their age or skin color and police brutality against minorities are examples of the continuing racism in our country. It is a shame that these injustices continue still today. King's quote speaks directly to the situations that are cruel and unequal in this world. Even though racism still exists today, Martin Luther King Jr.'s famous quote is not going to fade. King is a legacy, and he made a change in our world. King helped simmer the conflicts of racism in his time. King wanted us to see the cold truth behind the justice system, and he motivated people to oppose injustice and racism everywhere. King wanted people to stop and make a stand for justice and not just ignore the unjust of the world. Dr. King wanted peace and equality for everyone. King's main point was to say that justice begins when we treat each other equally. That means everyone, everywhere, treating everyone equally. Thank you.
Hello, my name is Carter Benninghouse. I go to Manatee High School and I'm in 11th grade. Injustice anywhere is a threat to justice everywhere. As I watched my baby brother bow his head on the sideline, I couldn't help but feel sadness for him. "I did so good in practice," he had told me. "I just know the coach will let me play in the championship game." But the minutes on the clock ticked away as he sat on the cold bench, watching the game through his teary eyes. The game finally ended with a win for my brother's competitive basketball team. They had won the championship without the help of my baby brother. As my mother packed away her camera, which hadn't been used at all during the game, I asked her how she could let the coach do this to her baby little boy. My mom smiled and said that the coach had his reasons and that we should respect his choices. My brother had known that accepting a spot on the competitive team might mean limited playing time. However, he never imagined it meant zero playing time. "It isn't fair," I screamed at my mother. My mom looked at me and told me lovingly that many things in life aren't fair. I didn't quite understand the power of that statement at that moment. As children, we want everything to be fair. As adults, we expect everything to be fair. If we don't receive something that we feel we are entitled to, it makes us upset. But what if we receive punishment that we're not supposed to receive? What if we are reprimanded for someone else's mistake? Sadly, our judicial system is not fair. Dr. Martin Luther King rallied for equality for all. He said, "Injustice anywhere is a threat to justice everywhere." Dr. King argued that the world is full of biased people. He explained that if two people commit the same crime, one of those people will be judged differently, solely dependent on the color of their skin. How can a fair system target some people while letting others go free? I have been raised to be kind to others. Through the guidance of my parents, I have always tried to be respectful and compassionate to others. My mom taught me at a very young age that every person in this world deserves kindness, even the people who don't act like they deserve it. There have been a few times that I've been embarrassed to reach out to someone, looked down upon, or made fun of, but I have always risen above those fears and followed my heart. Ignoring my feelings would cause me great distress, knowing that I could have made a difference, but chose instead to conform. Dr. Martin Luther King delivered a call for peace and equality that many consider a masterpiece. During his famous 17-minute speech, Dr. King warned us about the dangers of keeping silent. He asked us to speak up and protest whenever we encountered injustice or prejudice. Dr. King struggled to make us understand that it is wrong to stand back and watch injustice happen. He encouraged us to use our voices to push back against the forces that could possibly hurt our society forever. But have you ever thought about how potentially harmful silence could really be? After reflecting on this famous quote, I have come to a personal, deep understanding of the true meaning of his heartfelt words. I believe that by remaining silent, I could potentially hurt myself, allowing someone else to become hurt, and encourage others to continue to hurt others. None of us should remain silent. Through our silence, the world will continue to be unjust. We must come together as one unit and stand strong against bias and injustice. How can we accomplish equality? The first step is to be the best person we can be. We must strive to respect every human being in the same way. We must not allow our personal binders to filter through people, grouping them by skin color or cultural beliefs. All men were created equal, and it's time for us to believe and respect that. Thank you.
My name is Carrie Lindberg. I am in 10th grade at Manatee High School. Acts of injustice have been coursing through the veins of humankind since the beginning of our species. But despite the endless mass shootings, unbridled acts of terrorism, and simple, everyday occurrences of prejudice, many American citizens view these vicious acts as little more than stories in the news. For many, what doesn't directly affect them doesn't matter. The people who believe that injustice towards another person, no matter how far away, doesn't make a difference, could not be any further from the truth. In the wise words of Dr. Martin Luther King Jr., injustice anywhere is a threat to justice everywhere. In this day and age, information can be spread around the whole world within minutes. News of a violent account of racism, for example, could gain the attention of other extremists with the exact same ideals. That single injustice, however horrible it may be, could almost instantly multiply into a global catastrophe worse than any single hate crime caused by those who harbor unnecessary abhorrence. Even if all but one small account of injustice are contained, the single action that escapes the control of those who seek equality can easily turn from a single murder to the slaughter of many. The remaining existence of injustice does not only spark those who believe in the violence, it can also dispirit those who seek to end the acts of hatred. Imagine being someone who simply wants the right to love whom you wish, watching in terror as a mass shooting of 50 homosexual victims is reported. Imagine being a women's rights activist and seeing men endlessly demoralize your female colleagues into little more than possessions used for human pleasure. Imagine being an African American mother or father and hearing of the murder of an African American child not much older than your own due to inexcusable police brutality. Though tragic occurrences such as these sometimes offer a rallying point, they also discourage and dishearten many who try to fight against injustice. A person's soul can only take so much hatred before it gives up. We as humans were placed on this earth exactly the same, naked, vulnerable, and yearning for acceptance. Judgment placed due to trivial things such as race, gender, religion, and sexuality were non-existent when we were infants. We simply wanted to love and to be loved. And for many people who live in safe places, we have received all we crave and require for more than survival, but for prosperity. Except our world is not works of separately and ornately carved statues of picture-perfect people and families. The earth is made up of billions of chipped, cracked, and sometimes crumbling pillars that struggle to hold up what we have come to accept as our present reality. Some pillars are carved from precious stones, others barely shaped wood. But in the end, we all simply serve to work together to carry the weight of the world. However, when acts of injustice occur and are either ignored or overlooked, individual pillars begin to fall. Though they may seem insignificant at first, these pillars are much more than lost support. They are people who were born the exact same as everyone else, with just as much potential, love, and hope. The empty space that is left when they finally collapse only allows room for more division and more hatred. And when enough of the pillars fall, our world crumbles. It no longer matters who had been on top before, when they don't have anyone left to stand on. Martin Luther King Jr.'s quote, "Injustice anywhere is a threat to justice everywhere," refers to much more than simply meeting the demands of the oppressed. It means that the balance of our world depends on everyone treating each other with love, acceptance, and respect, no matter the differences between us.
Good evening. My name is Kevin Townsend, and I'm a senior at Manatee High School. Injustice is defined as a lack of fairness or justice. As Dr. Martin Luther King Jr. once said, and I quote, "Injustice anywhere is a threat to justice everywhere." Injustice isn't a new occurrence. It's been a cancer to society and the world around us since the beginning of history. The killing of Native Americans, slavery, the Holocaust, the Rwandan genocide, racism, and women in the Middle East. These situations are all real-world examples of a lack of fairness and just treatment. To me, this quote provokes some thought. Are we going to allow injustice to occur in our society today? These unfair situations hinder the foundations of justice that have been fought for all over the world. The controversial killings of Black lives almost divided America. Once again, religious conflict in the Middle East created a war zone. ISIS has become an extreme world threat, and the neighboring countries are stuck in a difficult situation. Let's not forget about gun control, Planned Parenthood, prison reform, data security, and immigration. Our current problems in the world affect every community and society. They make it hard for other countries to maintain the justice they have established because the people will get involved and these problems will spread. Our world's many distractions can make most of us overlook injustices or even make us believe that it couldn't happen to us. For example, America is believed to be one of the greatest countries in the world by many. Because of this, many people believe problems in other countries have no chance of coming into America and affecting them directly. This is the reason why most injustices don't get recognized unless it has a direct effect on this country or it has media coverage. As a whole, we are more concerned about our justices rather than the injustices that manipulate them. We should focus more on the problems we face as a society to ensure that our justices are maintained forever. As Robert Kennedy once said, and I quote, "Each time a man stands up for an ideal, or acts to improve the lot of others, or strikes out against injustice, he sends forth a tiny ripple of hope, and crossing each other from a million different centers of energy and daring. Those ripples build a current that can sweep down the mightiest walls of oppression and resistance." Unquote. The best fight against injustice and unfairness as a whole starts with leaders and people who aren't afraid to stand for what's right. These justice warriors will influence a wave of people that will follow their footsteps and continue the path to justice. In conclusion, is it impossible to be free of injustice? That's why we must choose the life we want to live and stop injustices wherever we are. Justice is beautiful and knows no color or difference, but injustice is brutal and oppressive and fuels the fire that burns unfair treatment and behavior. When others face the demon that is injustice, it should provoke them to prevent others from facing the same problems that they did. Thank you.
I'm Brianna Wallace, and I'm from Manatee High School, and I'm in 12th grade. In this world, people are oblivious. People are selfish. Events of social injustice, such as inequality, shootings, and discrimination, happen all the time. However, if it's not a tragedy, people are quick to turn the other cheek. Martin Luther King once said, "Injustice anywhere is a threat to justice everywhere." He later states, "Whatever affects one directly affects us all indirectly." For instance, there was a shooting in Orlando nightclub called Pulse. It was an attack on the LGBT, lesbian, gay, bisexual, and transgender community. Floridians were not the only ones concerned about this tragic event. There are people all around the world who gave their condolences. I believe MLK's quote is the epitome of the way society should aspire to be: equal and selfless. We are not equal. As a child, I was not aware of that. My only concerns were learning how to ride a bike and stealing cookies out of the cookie jar. In 2016, there are still multiple incidents of social injustice every day. It has been almost 60 years after the Civil Rights Movement, and we still have to deal with social injustices like discrimination. Instead of taking a step forward, our society has taken a major step back. It seems like we're still in the 1960s, where Black people had to fight for their rights and equality. Unfortunately, there are still cops who act cruel and jobs who only hire certain races. Today, there are even more equality movements like the Black Lives Matter campaign. Anyone can be a culprit of racial discrimination, even our own families. For instance, my mom and I are shunned by our extended family because we are different. We don't act ghetto. We aren't loud around strangers. We don't listen to the stereotypical Black music. These are factors that shouldn't matter to families, but has somehow put a strain on our relationship. Discrimination does not always pertain to race, but gender and sexuality too. Women still fight for their equal rights. They want to have equal pay and health care. The LGBT community may have gained their right to marry, but has not stopped the discrimination against them. Social injustices like discrimination and inequality are always broadcasted on the news, but no one cares. People will claim they do care. They'll pretend to be appalled that discrimination is still happening. They'll participate in movements, put bumper stickers on their cars, and claim we are all equal, but still refuse to work with the opposite race. The only time people care is when social injustices become tragedies, where multiple lives are lost. Why don't people care when social injustices only affect one life? The world needs to learn to be more selfless. When social injustices happen, we need to step up and give our support. After the Orlando shooting, people all over Florida donated blood to help out. However, there are some people who donated their blood who never cared to donate. They only donated their blood that one time to make themselves feel better. These are the type of people who jump on the "I need to help" bandwagon. Folks, caring is not better than not caring at all. In conclusion, the world is not black or white. The world is not filled with good or bad, light or dark. We all live among the gray. Sirius Black of the Harry Potter series once said, "The world isn't split into good people and Death Eaters." We've all got both light and dark inside us. What matters is the part we choose to act on. That's who we really are. Our world may not have wizards and Death Eaters, but Sirius Black does speak the truth. If we can choose to discriminate and be cruel, then we can choose to be selfless and treat each other as equals.
Good evening, I'm Emma Johnson, and I'm a 10th grader at Manatee High School. Dr. Martin Luther King Jr. was a truly amazing human being, not only leading the civil rights movement for equality among all races, but also inspiring future generations to peacefully combat hatred and bigotry. Dr. King used his words to spark action, and his actions to spark change. One of his most famous quotes is from his letter from Birmingham Jail, in which Dr. King declared that injustice anywhere is a threat to justice everywhere. Although these words were penned over 50 years ago, they still bear a meaning more timeless than words themselves. Humans are unavoidably divided throughout Earth, whether physically divided by living in different parts of the Earth, culturally divided by race or ethnicity, or socially divided through gender or class. Despite this, there is one integral thing that unites all humans in all parts of the world, with every background and every living condition. We are all humans, and we all share one planet. Therefore, humans cannot and must not claim that one injustice is insignificant or irrelevant to their life. For even if that wrong is not being committed directly against them, the effects of it are still present and pertinent. Human lives are the foliage that adorn the tree that is Earth. While the leaves may be on different branches, they are still on the same tree. And while they are not directly dependent upon each other for survival, they are directly dependent upon each other for prosperity. Just as how a tree suffers from one branch being neglected sunlight, when one population is denied rights, the population that is denying those rights and all other populations also suffer. Such a paradoxical relationship is evident time and time again throughout history. Dr. King fought the oppression faced by many African Americans in his time, from receiving lower quality education to suffering a racial wage gap. African Americans and other blacks were, to say the least, treated unequally to their white friends, coworkers, and neighbors. Many whites of the time acknowledged the lack of equal rights, but failed to act upon their observations, for they saw no negative implication of the inequality of blacks in their own lives. Here, Dr. King faced a problem much more extreme than not being allowed to drink from a water fountain because of the color of his skin. The fundamental problem Dr. King faced in his monumental movement was with the justification behind the racial oppression of African Americans. Many white Americans believed that, since I am not black, I am not affected by racism, so why should I care? Not only does this excuse show a complete lack of compassion towards others, it also demonstrates an absence of understanding of the connection between all human lives. By white Americans preventing African Americans from having quality education opportunities, they deprive themselves of possible scientists, doctors, teachers, and world leaders. By constantly reinforcing the rumor that whites were superior to blacks, the whites undermine the cultural identity of the black community, robbing themselves of a richer cultural exchange of ideas, traditions, and innovations. Racism is only one of a myriad of instances where injustices of one group can have a profound effect on justice everywhere. While the work of Dr. King and countless others has significantly improved the problem of racial injustice in the United States, there is still work to be done within this country's borders and around the world. And during our constant quest for a more secure and prosperous future, all must be compassionate, for no work will ever be done and no progress ever made if humans remain stuck in the delusion that one regional crisis or a single intolerance does not have a profound effect on the rest of humanity.
My name is Kelsey Ellsworth. I go to Manatee High School and I'm in 10th grade. Injustice is defined as lack of fairness or justice, but that simple definition does not begin to describe what injustice has caused throughout history. Martin Luther King Jr. once said, "Injustice anywhere is a threat to justice everywhere." This quote shows the unfairness to people of color in the judicial system of America. In the time of the Civil Rights Movement, people of color were being jailed for crimes they didn't commit. And unfortunately, that still happens today. In context, this quote talks about the injustice of Martin Luther King Jr.'s unfair jailing. He was put into confinement because he was protesting against segregation. Even though they were peaceful, he was still put in jail for the protest being unwise and untimely. King spoke of the fact that he was in prison based on the color of his skin, and this prejudice still occurs today. Many are put in prison due to the color of their skin, even if it was not them who committed the crime. Today, innocent black men and women are shot by police when they are being pulled over. The way people of color are treated by law enforcement, judges, and juries is sickening. The people of the civil rights movement, such as King, want to change, and we have only failed them with prejudice. This injustice is a threat to justice everywhere. This quote shows the impact of injustice. When one is treated unfairly, it becomes a threat of corruption everywhere. When someone is put through the judicial system, there are many factors that contribute to the outcome of their trial, one of these being the color of their skin. While this should not affect the sentencing, racial prejudice is still well alive in the judicial system. Juries and judges may still believe in untrue stereotypes that change their view of the innocent, and this affects the sentence they give, all of this based on the color of someone's skin. Unfortunately, this happens more often than many think. It happened 60 years ago, and it still occurs today. This injustice can happen anywhere and is a threat to justice everywhere. To me, this quote opened my eyes. I realized during my research that the judicial system is still prejudiced today. I've seen cases where a white person will commit a heinous crime and serve little to 3 months, while a black person will commit a misdemeanor and give their life. The system does not sentence fairly, and it never has. The injustice of the small town you may live in contributes to the corruption of justice everywhere. This quote was applied to the civil rights movement, and the people in that movement hoped and worked for change in the future. This quote only proves that there has been only little change of amount of prejudice in the judicial system of America. There needs to be change.
My name's Kiana Hawthorne. I go to Manatee High School and I'm a senior. Injustice anywhere is a threat to injustice everywhere, said by Dr. Martin Luther King Jr. The meaning of this quote is obvious. This quote is very simple to understand, but too many people don't. Whenever an injustice act is done to someone, everyone needs to put themselves in the mindset of, what would it take for that same act to be done to me? Very sad to say, but some people today still don't understand it. But a person of color can only hope they don't become the next statistic or hashtag. This quote affects me personally simply because what can happen to a person of color can definitely happen to me. If you look around the world today, and especially during the election, you can see the division of the nation's people. History seems to repeat itself, especially when you see the discrimination towards people who make up the culture and life of America. Racially, you see people protesting against police brutality, but the sad thing about it is that African Americans have been racially profiled for decades. Injustice against black people affects me, my black friends, and family because it can happen to us. It can most certainly happen to us if we are in the wrong place at the wrong time, or we look intimidating, or for having our hands up when instructed to do so, or sitting in a car with our loved ones, or playing on a playground, or in a church, or even selling CDs. The criminal justice system needs to develop a stronger relationship between law enforcement and the communities they work in with methods that will de-escalate situations at hand rather than using deadly force. This quote directly shows the significance on how we should end racial profiling by state, federal, and local law enforcement. The definition of racial bias is when attitudes or stereotypes from a particular group that affects our understanding, actions, and decisions in an unconscious manner. We need to treat everyone equal and not target only some people, but let others escape if they don't fit the criteria. Everything needs to be weighed on the merits of the trial and the principle we uphold as a nation. Anything less is, by default, injustice. If we allow injustice to happen to some people, we threaten everyone. The way the justice system is set up is that we allow people to believe that an act done unjustly towards anyone can be justified. This attitude has spread and it will continue to spread. Then more people will eventually act unjustly and unfairly in more settings. This will only harm our entire society rather than help us fix it. So when any act of injustice has been done, it doesn't just threaten the people surrounding the community, it threatens the whole nation far and wide. Thank you.
Hi, my name is Gabrielle Francois. I'm in 11th grade and I attend Southeast High School. It is happening now. Like many members of my generation, I grew up learning about the injustices that have occurred throughout the world since I was a child. The Trail of Tears, the capturing and forced servitude of millions of Africans, the Holocaust, and the denial of basic human rights to millions of Americans due to the color of their skin, sex, religion, or nationality. These were all taught to me in school as a testament to the consequences of vast intolerance. One question I always asked myself as I learned about these tragedies, as I read the personal accounts of people who survived them, as I watched documentaries on these events showing how truly devastating they were, was how could this all have happened? How could people have carried on with their day as if their neighbor, their friend, as if their fellow brothers and sisters were not being treated as less than what they were? It was incomprehensible. I vowed and promised myself that if I were to ever live in a time where vile acts like those returned, my voice would not go unheard. Because even at a young age, I understood that injustice anywhere was a threat to justice everywhere. But today, as I stand before you, injustice is occurring. It pains me as I watch peaceful protesters being subject to police brutality and violence, even though all they are fighting for is basic human rights. It pains me to know that in one of the most developed countries, thousands remain without clean water. More than all, it pains me to see people justifying these unjustifiable actions. In the words of Dr. King, injustice anywhere is a threat to justice everywhere. These bold words invoke the legacy of the fearless men and women who risked their lives to fight against injustice. No other quote highlights the fundamental problem with the struggle that the indigenous peoples in North Dakota have faced. Native Americans have a long history of persecution. They were labeled as savages and told that their way of life and their culture was wrong. They were belittled and dehumanized as foreign intruders invaded their land and took over, and were even forced to assimilate into a culture that was not their own. After centuries of treating them as lesser, it is incomprehensible that centuries later I would bear witness to the heinous acts that have been taken against them today. With the unjustifiable violence these Native Americans have been subjected to, One would ask, what cause could these people find so important that they would be willing to risk their lives for it? Water. They are fighting for their right to clean water. They do not want to take the risk of having oil spill from the pipelines, thus contaminating their water source. Their cause is valid. And the fact that the pipeline was rerouted through Standing Rock because the residents of another area feared it would poison their drinking water proves its validation. In the words of a protester against the pipeline, it is not just about the natives in the pipeline fight. It's about humanity and saving all of us as a whole. It is happening now. The depressing, dangerous tide of intolerance and injustice that activists like Dr. King fought against is slowly beginning to overwhelm and overtake our nation. Though we seek and speak out for international justice, our very own justice system remains complacent in establishing true justice here in America. 2.3 million Americans sit behind bars as we speak. The United States is home to about 5% of the world's population, but makes up 25% of the world's prisoners. We have the highest number of prisoners of any developed country. This all due to a justice system that has time and time again failed to provide justice to those who need it the most, locking up the innocent and acquitting the guilty. Today, we live in a nation where the Supreme Court recognizes that there is racial bias in the death penalty, but refuses to do anything about it. This is injustice. Today, we live in a nation where innocent people are shot to death at the hands of those who swore an oath to serve and protect, and no one is punished. This is injustice. Today, we live in a nation where an entire city has been without clean water for over a year. This is injustice. We don't have to go far to see the injustices occurring in the world. It is happening in our own country. It is happening now. These events are not in our history books. Rather, they are a glimpse into the reality of our world today. It is up to me. It is up to you. It is up to us as a nation, as human beings, to stand up and speak out when injustice occurs around us. May we be the voice for the silence. May we rise up and lead the fight against injustice. May we be a beacon of hope for the hopeless. May we not disregard others' pains because we feel as though it does not directly affect us. It does. Because as Dr. Martin Luther King Jr., a leader who dedicated his life to fighting against injustice, once said, "Injustice anywhere is a threat to justice everywhere." Thank you.
Good evening. My name is Felicity DiGaetano. I go to Manatee High School, and I am in the 10th grade. Injustice anywhere is a threat to justice everywhere. Dr. Martin Luther King Jr. spoke for peace, equality, and justice for everyone. In today's bustling world of electronics, where our thoughts are so often blinded by the media, it sometimes is hard to acknowledge the injustices that still take place now. Especially in the time of this election, the nation has become divided in ways just now noticeable to the public. People of different sex, race, and beliefs are attacked, whether it be online or in person, due to the voices on TV. It only takes one spark to make a flame, and one act of injustice can affect everyone else. Students may be sitting in class and someone makes a rape joke. If no one speaks out, it would be presumed that what they said was okay. If other students laugh, then they may start making similar jokes. This is what Dr. King meant when he said injustice is a threat to justice. One cruel remark could create a wave of evil. Children could be born into a world where they think girls are less than boys, whites are better than blacks, and there is only one religion that's true. To have justice is to have the ability to think freely, do freely, and be looked at as an equal. For one to think that justice is limited to one certain group of people is to destroy what humans are entirely. Injustice feeds off of ignorance. People need to know that we are all different. We are all unique. For someone to be so closed-minded and unaccepting of different people is worthy of pity. One ignorant person is a threat to a whole group of individuals. In our modern times, a single comment or video can be accessed by millions of people. Thousands of those will be young children influenced by the words they see across their computer screens. Children are the worst target when it comes to injustice, as they have families who have their own opinions on how the world should be. The kids feed off of that. Any comment by family members or even random internet bullies is a threat to the individuality beginning to blossom in any child's heart. They will grow up either being small-minded or belittled if they have other people around them spreading horrible ideas on the way they believe life should be. Justice need not be earned. A baby should be born with the ability to grow into their skin, their sexuality, their beliefs, without being tormented. Injustice can be spread so much faster than justice, so more people need to stand up for what's right. That's why a single act of injustice is a huge threat. It's like quicksand. We need to stop relying on technology in this day and age and go outside, talk to others, spread kindness and acceptance. You cannot change the world with a whimper. The world will only change if the majority speaks out against injustice, stands up for the victims, the minorities, and stops the negative voices. Dr. Martin Luther King Jr. would want our nation's children to grow up in a world of love, not hate. Justice can overcome the overbearing injustice, but all it needs is a spark. Thank you.
Well, that was quite an event. Let's give all of our contestants a round of applause. So the judges are gonna take a little bit of time to calculate the results, and the winners will be announced tonight, I promise you. It's just gonna take us a little bit of time. So in the meantime, please enjoy the refreshments that are available over here to my left, and we will be back as soon as we can. Thank you. Of applause one more time. Gonna make you wait a little bit longer. Before I announce the winners, I would first like to recognize all of our sponsors, the Herald, the Bradenton Herald, for advertising this event. Bells for providing the gifts that the finalists will receive tonight. MCR Health Services for providing the plaques that the winners will receive. The Tillis Tutoring Center for providing the cash prizes for the winners. Dr. Mary Tillis for working with the children. Once we announce our winners, they'll go through a training session next week, and she's going to work with them to get them ready for their presentation. So I want to recognize Mrs. Tillis. CSNL and Blaylock Walters will be providing the computers, nice Dell laptop computers and printers for the grand prize winners. So thank you to them. I always say this, but we could not put on this wonderful program without our sponsors. So we thank you, thank you, thank you. So before I announce the winners, I have some certificates for each of our contestants here tonight and some goodies. Have my staff. So, first certificate goes to Carly Baker. Darius Beckford. Carter Beddinghouse. Jasper Belsham. Alexa Bland. Felicity Dalgatano. Aiden Delk. Bella Dobronsky. Kelsey Ellsworth. Gabrielle Francois. Sarah Hampton. Kiana Hawthorne. Emma Johnston. Madison Lee. Simone Leong. Carrie Ann Lindberg. Sullivan Molly. Hannah Ramston. Kevin Townsend. Brianna Wallace. Rebecca Watchers. Allison Whiteman. Luke Wilson. Did you want to say some words loudly?
So.
Now on to our winners. In the middle school category, our honorable mention, who will receive a cash prize of $50, Felicity Dacartano. In third place, and the winner of $75, Kevin Townsend. You know what I just realized? I'm reading the high school category. But that's okay. We'll keep going. In second place in the high school category, and the winner of $100, Carter Bettinghouse. Our grand prize winner in the high school category, the winner of a brand new Dell laptop computer and printer, and $150, Gabrielle Francois. Okay, now on to our middle school category. Our honorable mention in the middle school category and the winner of $50, Hannah Ramston. Place in the middle school category, and the winner of $75, Bella Dabrowski. In second place, and the winner of $100, Sullivan Molly. And in first place in the middle school category, the winner of a new Dell laptop computer and printer, and $150 is Alexa Bland. And that concludes tonight's ceremony. I would like to thank each and every one of you for coming out. And if I can see all of the winners back here right after I conclude. So have a good night. Thank you.